Mission State has a rich history. Several places on campus commemorate the tradition. From the 50-foot-tall Blaston Bell Tower to the alumni fountain outside the Dan Rather Building, these are just a few of the structures that make San Houston State University beautiful. The 20-foot-tall San Houston statue near the Smith Coastal Building is an exact replica of the one located on I-45. One of the less than known markers on campus is the headstone tripod dog, who has the school's unofficial mascot from 1941 to 1962. The Hensville Hall Public Library is offering a free animation class. The class is called Voice Animators, held once a week on Wednesdays from 3:30. So animators will teach members how to create their own characters and customize an animated video in various forms. The class is offered from teenagers from 11 to 17 with supplies provided by the library. As construction spreads throughout the campus, students adapt to the environment. Construction has now pushed on towards 20th Street where students cross to get to class. The construction affects local businesses as well. Several apartments that have provided shelter places to students now have to drive around the construction. The new area where students get picked up and dropped off is on Avenue I, where students have to either stand or sit on the curb. Josh, who runs one of the shuttle buses, says that this is a change has to put student schedules off so much that they have to stop riding the shuttle altogether. Cyclists and skateboarders on the San Houston campus currently are not much of an issue, but this fall, however, could be a problem if the current guidelines are not met. According to the student handbook, bikes and skateboards are only to be ridden in the streets, parking lots, and bikeways. Bicycles might be welcome to areas on campus with heavy foot traffic, such as sidewalks or the mall areas. Failure to comply with these policies can result in citation or impoundment. San Houston State enforces these policies to ensure the safety of everyone on campus. Huntsville children spent some time with furry friends from around the world on one afternoon. The Huntsville Public Library hosted Wild Things in Food Bar for an afternoon program Thursday to a packed room. The Austin-based Cuddle Zoo and Animal Show brought a young wallaby, lemur, who carried a baby warthog for kids to see and pet. With Cortina Pineda, children learned about various living habitats and the need for exotic animals. The program also shared general information about animals' health and behavior. Cortina Pineda also discussed the potential for mitigating animals to end up in danger due to habitat destruction, human interference, and the need to preserve them for the future. Three players from the San Houston State baseball team were drafted by the Major League Baseball organization. Catcher Robbie Rojas, pitcher Pete Donica, and center field Bryce Johnson were all selected by three different teams. Robbie Rojas was selected in the 38th round by the Milwaukee Brewers, and Pete Donica was selected in the 21st round by the Oakland Athletics. And Bryce Johnson was selected in the 6th round by the San Francisco Giants. Rojas led the Knicks in 2016 with the most number of runners caught stealing. He also had one of the best batting averages of the Bearcats teams. Donica was nominated in 2017 with 109 strikeouts, the most Division I program lore and the second most in the team history. The 2205 career ranked fourth by the Bearcat and was named Southland Pitcher of the Year with a 6-0 recording league play. Bryce Johnson did a 3 seasons with the Bearcats, posted a 9.338 average while making 107 total strikes. Also leads the San Houston with the 32-40 games and 12 multiple RBI attempts. Johnson, who stole 33 in the 2017 season, was named first team All-Southland Conference. All players and head coach Matt Diggs are expected to what comes next. Looking outside, it's currently 87 degrees, but it feels like 96 degrees, with a humidity of about 75%, with winds coming to the southeast at about 10 miles per hour. The sky is mostly cloudy with a 50% chance of rain, but for tonight, we will reach a low of 72 degrees, feeling like staying with partly cloud skies at 1 a.m. Today, the pollen count for tree pollen is low, and for ragweed pollen is moderate, but for mold, it's low, and for grass pollen, it's low as well. Umbrellas might come in handy if you're going to be outside at the weekend. Saturday, mostly cloudy with a chance of rain, while Sunday will be partly cloudy with a 40% chance of rain. Let's take a look at a 7-day forecast. Well, that's all the time we have for today. Thank you for joining us.